Hey guys, welcome back. Well, we have a jungle. I hope you enjoyed the live I did last night. So these little trees are from the chow. Sometimes the machine doesn't grind it 100%, you'll get these trees. So what I do is I just lift them up and I just put them back down and it becomes more food for the worms. So today I want to check on this pumpkin. I went Bigfoot hunting. I couldn't find him. Bummer, you know. So let's check on the pumpkin. Oh boy, I haven't checked on this pumpkin in a few days because I was out hunting for Bigfoot. Feels nice and warm over here, but not heating up like terrible. They seem to love it. So let's see what's going on down here. Oh boy, they're moving in. Look at them all. So these are red wigglers, also known as Hessenia fetida. Yeah, this bedding here is nice and warm, but it's not terrible warm, like they're gonna run. I had to turn the heat on in the house already because it's starting to get cool down here. And I just want to make sure that they're comfortable. Oh, look, there's a cocoon. See that little yellow lemon thing? And another one, that's a cocoon. So when they're yellow like that, they just were laid. And when they're ready to hatch, they start turning like a maroon. Sometimes it's hard for me to find them when they're going to hatch because they blend so well with the bedding. Let's see. There's a new one. I'll have to... When I find one, I'll have to just show you all. So I'm going to move this aside. Oh, look, this is a new one. Wow, this is like brand new. Let's see. They look like little lemons. And, you know, I don't ship cocoons because right now I just need my own stock. But cocoons ship very well. They don't get hurt in the shipping. The cold doesn't bother them. So let's give them their pumpkin back. I don't see a hole in this pumpkin yet, but I know that there's something going on around it because the worms are more and more every day I see them congregating around the pumpkin. So I'm just moving them all back. Let's all go back. Let's check over here in the corners and see. I always like to see what's going on in the corners. Oh, as you can see, there are worms over here in the corner too. Look at that. They're amazing, aren't they? Something's tickling my finger. There's a little one. Yeah, they're all over the place. And you see this, these green little trees from the worm chow. It just provides more food for them. So if that happens, it's not a problem. Just think of it as a bonus. So I really enjoyed doing the live last night. You know, I hadn't done one in a while. And it's great to, I get to talk to new people and people from like all over the world. I know that there were some on there that it was like 2 a.m. by them. And I really appreciate you watching at that time. So I know a lot of people want to learn and I'm really grateful for that. And, you know, you can always come to me and ask me. I'll tell you the truth. Sometimes it's easy to worm farm and most of the times it's not. But, you know, if you love it, go for it. You gotta love it, though. I'll tell you that. With any job, I think you gotta love it. I love checking on these guys every day just to see what they're doing. And... you know, in case I run into any problems, I can get it sooner, get ahead of it before it turns into like a major problem. This is only one of my tubs. I have 6. This is one of my fuller tubs though. So we're gonna cover that back up. And let me move on to the next tub. Okay. Tub number two. Looks like the same situation. A lot of little trees. And let's check out what the pumpkin's doing. A lot of little trees. All right, let's lift this up. Yeah, same situation. They're all down there. I think the pumpkin is starting to build up some bacteria or microbes. So they're all congregating here to eat. And look, they're all down here. Is the temperature feels the same? Maybe a slightly bit cooler than the other one. Now, I could easily go get my temperature gauge. But, you know, guys, sometimes my hands are a better thermometer than any gauge. Because I have learned from experience, like, what it feels like or what it should feel like. And, oh, look, there's a breeding pair right there. There they are. So yeah, that way if there's any problems, you know, I could catch it right away. And trust me, I've had problems in the past. Oh my gosh, have I had problems? But you know, that's how I learned, by just figuring out what went wrong and doing everything I can to fix it. See more little trees over here. Let's check out the corners. Same thing. A lot of little worms. This bedding is nice and moist, but at the same time, it's starting to get fluffy, which is what I absolutely love. To me, that is like the perfect consistency. When it starts to feel fluffy, but it's moist, that means there's good oxygen in there. They're doing a good job. They're very happy. So when I go like this, I don't squeeze really hard because I don't want to like burst any cocoons. I just kind of like, you know, fluff it up with your fingers a little. And you're not going to hurt them that way. This corner has a lot for some reason. So these pumpkin things are doing good. I'm glad that I was able to get some pumpkins for them, because pumpkin is one of the favorite food of a composting worm. Pumpkin, sweet potato is another big one because of the sweetness, and watermelon. You just have to watch when you feed something like watermelon, because watermelon is very wet and you don't want to feed watermelon and then spray a lot your bin, because you're going to create like a soggy mess and you don't need that. That'll just create problems for you. So this is doing good. So these tubs, I get these on Amazon. I'll do my best to link it. I find them the most comfortable for me. And they're a nice size because, you know, when you're raising composting worms, they don't really have to be very deep. Now, the grow out bins over there, those are about 3 inches deep, more or less. These are more, but they don't have to be like, you know, like a foot deep or anything like that. Because red wigglers, you know, they eat in the top 4 to 6 inches. So they're surface feeders. So let's go to the one over here that has the burlap. Ah, look. Little trees are growing through. Just going to lift them up. There we go. Let's see in here. Yeah, they really like this stuff. They're doing very well. I'm very pleased with them. Guys, I don't know how long this is going to take to break down, though. I'll tell you that. I know it will eventually. But you see, if I would have frozen that pumpkin first, defrosted it, and then put it in here, I think by now it would have probably been mostly gone. But I chose not to do that this time, just to do something different and see what happens. Oh, my avocado is still hanging in. Just to see what happens, you know, something different. So even though the pumpkin is in the middle, the worms are still all over this entire bin, which is a good sign because that means that they're happy. They're coming and going out of the middle. They're just everywhere. If you have like food in here or something and you see worms congregating to one end only, something is going on. Something is definitely going on. So you got to like check it out. All right. Springtails. Springtails are not going to hurt your worms. They are the little white things you see in here. They are part of the composting world. They do sometimes get in abundant numbers. And if that happens, just dry out your worm bin a little bit. Like, don't wet it. But make sure it's still a little moist for the worms to be okay. And the springtails disappear. You can also add diatomaceous earth on the surface. Like the one that says food grade. And that'll take care of them also. But, you know, sometimes they just start multiplying like crazy and they want to compete for the food and they want to take over. But, you know, your worms are priority, so you just got to calm them down a little bit. So what do you think, guys? Anyway, I'll keep you updated on these. So if you haven't subscribed yet, hit that subscribe button and share my videos on your Facebook pages or other social media so people can backlink it. Back to my YouTube channel. You know, YouTube watches these things because they tell me about it. They say so and so, you know, they don't tell me who, but they say the amount of people. Look at the springtails. This is a piece of avocado skin, I think. Yep. So see them? And they're fine. They're enjoying this, so I just put them right back. So anyway, like and subscribe, and hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time. Take care.